My name is Matthew. I live in the number one most livable city in the world, Vancouver, British Columbia. There are many new communities springing up in this growing city. Falls Creek, Cole Harbour, and Yale Town. I chose my place based on location. It's a block from the beach, minutes from downtown, and close to my work. I live in the jewel of Vancouver. I live in Stanley Park.
I found the place about 3 years ago, just on a hike one day in the woods.
They were going to turn my building into an ESL school. I squatted for 4 months until police escorted me out. I knew in the back of my mind that this was coming, so I had prepared an old growth stump as my new home.
I knew people already that lived in the park, Ian and James, and they already had an established camp, so it made it much easier just to, you know, in seeing how they lived, functioned, for me to adapt and be able to live in here.
I don't really consider myself homeless because, you know, I got a place I can go where I can sleep comfortably and not have to worry about somebody coming in and terrorizing me, I guess. Yeah, a place I can go to and escape, feel safe.
In the park, there is a certain area where men go and cruise other men. It's happened upon a couple occasions that I've been solicited for oral sex and make $50 from it. I never thought I would be actually in a situation where I would be selling myself for sex. However, those circumstances have arisen, so desperate times call for desperate measures.
The volume of stuff that people discard is appalling. Everything from cell phones to Blackberries to full catering spreads that, you know, it's like, oh my God, how can people just ditch this much food? So a Japanese student is going back to Japan. He doesn't need anything that he's got in his apartment. The whole thing goes to the curb. Find one of those scores, it's a good day. If I see and or find something that I know that person would be interested in, I take it to them. They give me money, snacks being drugs. I definitely have addiction to crystal. Being part of the, you know, club scene and being out in the nightlife and doing all that stuff for a short time when I moved here, it was just like gradual progression into, you know, just hanging out with friends and do a line or whatever.
I regret actually ever accepting the first flap of crystal. It didn't add to the experience. It didn't help me seek out help for the experiences that I was having. It made me more reclusive. It made me more antisocial. It's like a magnifying glass, just enlarges the wound.
Why am I here? I don't know yet. I haven't figured that out. In the big, big picture, why am I here? Partially from my own hand, partially from life's twists and, you know, throwing me curves, and this is how I've dealt with them. When you think it's just going hunky-dory and things are just great, you get thrown a wonderful curveball and it takes you right off and sets you right on your ass. And it can totally shatter your world.